It's been 3 weeks since passengers aboard an Alaska Airlines flight experienced this terrifying ordeal in midair. The emergency door of this Boeing 737 MAX 9 blew off moments after departing from Portland, Oregon. After the incident, the Federal Aviation Administration grounded more than 170 737s, forcing the cancellation of thousands of flights. But on Friday, the first of the passenger jets took to the sky again, but with very wary passengers. CBS senior transportation correspondent Kris has the story.
Cleared for takeoff, the first 737 MAX 9 back in the air. A nearly full Alaska Airlines Flight 1146 left Seattle for San Diego Friday afternoon, 3 weeks after a door panel blew out on another Alaska MAX 9 mid-flight. Virginia Cavani will be on board. She's traveling to see her family.
Thoughts go through your mind, but you have to hope that people learn from their mistakes.
The FAA grounded 171 MAX 9s, while the NTSB investigation focuses on whether the four bolts holding that door panel in place were properly installed. Loose bolts were also found on several other MAX 9s.
I mean, one plane out of how many it happened to, but they're fixing it, so I'm okay with that.
This weekend, Alaska and United Airlines are continuing inspections, allowing their MAX 9 fleets to return to service over the next several days, while NTSB investigators are back at Boeing's 737 factory in Renton, Washington.
The 737 MAX is a vital part of Boeing's business. They have a backlog of more than 4,300 orders from airlines around the world. In fact, the MAX makes up the vast majority of Boeing's outstanding orders.
Alaska and United say passengers who do not want to fly on a MAX 9 can change flights with no additional cost, as winning back the public's trust may take time.
Boeing has been called on the carpet more than enough to have a wake-up call, because it's not just about public confidence, it's about private confidence. It's about the airlines buying planes from Boeing.
With the world watching as the 737 MAX 9 tries to navigate through a crisis of confidence. For CBS Saturday Morning, I'm Kris Van Cleave in Renton, Washington.
No reaction.
We're reacting on three, I think. We could do that if
not.
You want. No.
Right.
There we go.
I was just going to say, I can't believe that after that, we travel so much.
Yeah.
I was a little leery about sitting in the window seat. And it was the first time I ever thought about that, to be honest.
See, I wasn't. And it's like,
I know, that's why I'm sort of surprised.
Right? So even though you're amazed, still, when you look at that video of when the door blew off, you're amazed. I'm like, how did that happen on a flight? But then still, you get right back on.
I know. I don't mean I wasn't getting on. It was the first time when sitting in a window seat, I went, no, I don't know if I want to be here.
Well, I've always been that seatbelt tightener.
Yeah.
Because I always think about what could go wrong on a flight.
But
that's
not.
Just, I'm not a flyer.
You keep it tight, no matter what, even if the seatbelt sign is off.
Yes, absolutely.